Hey guys, and welcome to another video. First of all, I want to say, please leave a subscribe. You would really help me out here and support my channel. I really always keep on doing nice stuff to show you, so I would really appreciate if you just hit that little subscribe button. That would be awesome. Okay, for today's video, we have the 3080 TUF OC on my test bench. I will just do some firmware tests with the already changed firmware pads. The car was running now for the last 3 weeks with those firmware pads, and I want to see how the firmwares went over the last 3 weeks. So we will check the car out, and then we will also use some cool copper plates on this car. Since I said on my last video with the TUF that I will do something cool to cool the car, I don't know if this works on this card. We will see it in the end. And yeah, let's just boot up the test bench and then we will see some firmware results and then we can keep on going. Alright, the card is now on my test bench. As you can see, running slightly over 2 minutes. And this card got indeed better, like I mentioned in the other video. Those firmware pads need to get a bit squeezed and then they will align later on. As you can see, we have 86 degrees Celsius. This is 4 degrees better than the last time we made the video, and also considering that the room temperature is, it's all also up again 3 degrees more. So all in all, the temperature is now 7 degrees better than in the last video, which is really cool to see that some pads need some time to sit on the memory correctly. But we will change the firmware pads for plates nonetheless. And yeah, we have now the result. 3 minutes is 86 degrees Celsius. Now let me put the card apart and then I will add some copper plates to this card. All right, as you can see, this is not a deassembled card. Also on this card, better safe than sorry. Make sure you cover all big capacitors. With big capacitors, I mean those that you can see here and here. That are the one that can get potentially shorted. All other stuff is unnecessary to cover, but those are the ones that you want to cover with, I don't know, some paint, some nail paint, or in my case, Kapton tape. Now I will put on the firmware, the copper plates, then we will see how it looks like, and then hopefully we get some nice firmness afterwards. And yeah, have you ever seen white memory stacks? That's how it looks like. Yeah, this is how it looks like from now. Looks a bit messy, but we will see how it works out in the end. I also can't believe that I'm doing this on this card. Yeah, the subframe is on, the copper plates are installed, and this is why I love the TUF, because you can see now if there is any problem, or if there would be any problem if you try to move such a copper shim. You can see nearly impossible to move those. All right, as you can see, mine is starting up 27 degrees Celsius on the memory. What I forgot to mention, after 3 minutes we had 88 degrees Celsius on the memory. Now we wait again 3 minutes and then we will see where the firmwares are. Alright, as you can see, the memory temperature is now 80 degrees Celsius. So we dropped off another 8 degrees Celsius, which is kind of okay. I did expect a bit more, but since the cooler of the TUF is a bit bad designed, yeah, that's what you can expect if you have the best firmware pads on the card. I hope you enjoyed the video anyways, guys. Leave down a comment or like, and if you want to subscribe, I would really appreciate it, and I would see you in the next video.